Really wanted to start this video holding a bunch of physical movies and dramatically throwing them in the air and talking about how silly it is to own physical media these days, but I don't own any physical media to throw in the air dramatically, so you'll just have to imagine with me. Hey, in this video I'm going to show you how to use Movies Anywhere to purchase digital movies, redeem digital codes, link to services such as Apple TV and Vudu, and share your digital movies with your friends. As I said a minute ago, I moved away from physical media a long time ago and have been a long time user of Movies Anywhere, and I think this is a must-use service for anybody who's considering making the switch over to digital content. I hope by the end of this you feel educated and empowered to go build your digital movie collection out on moviesanywhere.com or through the Movies Anywhere app on your mobile device. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like this video. Okay, so before we get into how to set up your account, you may be wondering why you even should. Movies Anywhere is essentially a middleman service between retailers like Apple and Google and Amazon that allows you to share purchases across these different retailers. So for example, let's say you purchase something on your Roku device, say through the Amazon Prime app, and now you're over on your iPad and you're wanting to watch that movie without having to go install the Amazon Prime app. Well, if you have all these services linked with Movies Anywhere, it will push that movie from Amazon Prime and share it out to all your other linked retailers. So when you open up your Movies app on your iPad, there you will see the purchased movie that you purchased over on Amazon Prime. Pretty neat, right? Okay, so to get started, you will obviously need to create your account. So head over to moviesanywhere.com on your computer or your mobile device through the Movies Anywhere app. Once logged in, the first thing that I'd recommend you do, and I believe the first thing it asks you to do, is to link all your retailers. And again, that's those Apple, Google, Amazon, Vudu, what have you, accounts. This is a very important step, so be sure you do it, because again, that's really the whole point of this whole thing. To link to these retailers, if it doesn't pop up and ask you, you'll simply go to your settings, manage retailers, and start logging into all the retailers that you have accounts with. Okay, so now that we have the basics out of the way, let's look into how you get new movies added into your Movies Anywhere library and shared out to all of your other retailers. And there are a couple different ways to do this. The first is simply through purchasing a movie. Now, remember, Movies Anywhere itself is not a retailer of movies, but you can still use it to search and find a movie, then click See Retailers, which will take you out to whichever platform you want to actually purchase the movie at. And once it's purchased, it will then sync over into your Movies Anywhere account. From there, it'll be pushed out to all your other linked retailers. The second way to get movies into your Movies Anywhere library is by redeeming a digital copy off of a physical piece of paper that is inside one of your physical Blu-ray or 4K movie boxes. You're going to find these little pieces of paper inside boxes that say Blu-ray and digital copy or 4K and digital copy. And not every code will be redeemable on the Movies Anywhere platform itself, but I'm generally able to redeem all movies on either Movies Anywhere or Vudu. On occasion, I have to go to some random website that's on that piece of paper, but usually after I go through that site, it offers me the option to redeem the code over on Vudu or Movies Anywhere. So just follow the steps that's provided to you on that card. Once the code's typed in, you'll have that movie now in your Movies Anywhere library, and again, shared out to all your other platforms. And finally, my favorite way and the way that I add most movies to my Movies Anywhere account is by purchasing a digital copy from somebody else. I prefer this method because it's the cheapest way to purchase movies and to build my digital collection, and it keeps things digital. I'm not having to go out and buy a physical copy of a movie just to get that digital code and then try to sell the physical copy. And I'm not having to pay top dollar through these platforms like Apple and Amazon when I can just buy that digital code from somebody who doesn't intend on redeeming it themselves. There are many places on the internet where you can go and find these digital codes, and I have another video detailing my preferred sources. You can find the link to that video up above or down in the description. And the last thing I want to cover in this video is the greatest feature of Movies Anywhere, which is called Screen Pass. Movies Anywhere is the only service that I'm aware of that offers a feature like this, and it's such an awesome feature because it allows you to lend out your digital copies of movies just like you used to be able to do when you owned a physical copy of a movie. So in a nutshell, what Screen Pass is a feature that allows you to choose one of your digital movies from your Movies Anywhere library, choose to Screen Pass that movie to a friend, and then they can watch it over on their Movies Anywhere account. Keep in mind, you can only do this 3 times per month. Those do not roll over to other months if you don't use them. And if you use them all in like a week, then at the end of that month, the counter will reset and you'll have 3 again the following month. To do this, you'll log into your Movies Anywhere account, go to your movies, and you'll have a section of Screen Pass eligible movies. Find the movie that you're wanting to share, click Screen Pass, and then send a Screen Pass. What this does is it provides you a link that you're able to send to your friend via email or text message. And once they click on that link, it redirects them to their Movies Anywhere account. Then they have the ability to watch that movie for up to 14 days. Once they've started the movie, they do have to finish it within 72 hours. Again, I love this feature because I'm not a big fan of giving my credentials out to people and having them log in and watch my movies, and I suppose they knew people would do that anyway. So instead of doing that, they've offered us the option to share our digital movies, again, like we used to do with our physical movies. And the neat thing about sharing your digital movies instead of your physical ones is you don't have to lose friends over people not giving you your movies back. Okay, that does it for this video. I hope you now have a better understanding of Movies Anywhere and can take advantage of some of the things we talked about in this video. Thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.